बॉडी मूवमेंट्स. व्हाट वी लर्न इन दिस टॉपिक? इन द टॉपिक बॉडी मूवमेंट्स वी लर्न अबाउट स्केलेटन. हाउ स्केलेटन इज मेड अप ऑफ? स्केलेटन इज मेड अप ऑफ बोन्स, जॉइंट्स एंड मसल्स. व्हाट डू मीन बाय बोन्स? बोन इज अ हार्ड स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, बोन्स कैन नॉट बी बेंड इफ कंबाइंड टू बोन्स. इफ बोन्स आर कंबाइंड एट ए सिंगल पॉइंट, बोन्स कंबाइंड एट अ सिंगल पॉइंट वी कॉल्ड एज जॉइंट. इट इज अ बोन. बोन्स कंबाइंड एट अ सिंगल पॉइंट वी कॉल्ड एज जॉइंट. जॉइंट्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स. वन इज इनमूवेबल जॉइंट्स एंड अनदर वन इज मूवेबल जॉइंट्स. इनमूवेबल जॉइंट्स मींस द जॉइंट्स विच आर नॉट मूव आर जॉइंट विच आर एट कॉन्स्टेंट पोजिशन वी कॉल्ड एज इनमूवेबल जॉइंट्स. एग्जाम्पल फॉर इनमूवेबल जॉइंट इज स्कल. स्कल इज वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल फॉर immovable joints. For movable joints means the joints which helps to move the body or the organ. So we call as movable joints. Here you go, knee, shoulder. These joints we call as immovable joints. Movable joints again classified as four types. One is ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joints helps to move our body. So, example for ball and socket joint is knee, shoulder. These are example for ball and socket joint. Second one is pivotal joint. Pivotal joint is we saw in our body. Pivotal joint is at the neck part. Head and neck connected at a joint. That joint we call as pivotal joint or pivotal bone. Next, third one is hinge joint. Hinge joint is also in our body. Hinge joint helps to move forward and to and fro or forward and backward position. That is hinge joint. Next one is fixed joint. Fixed joint helps in our body. Fixed joint also absorbs. We can observe in our body. Fixed joint means example is jaws, upper and lower jaws. This is that the lower part of the joint will be move, but the upper part is not movable. So that types of joints we call as fixed joints. Okay, dear students, we know and learned about so many varieties of joints and we know about the structure of skeleton. How skeleton is made up of? Skeleton is made up of bones. Let's see and identify skeleton contains how many bones and which are those. Observe the picture of skeleton. How skeleton is made up of? Skeleton is made up of bones and joints. And another cartilage and muscles are also there. But we learned about bones and joints only. So now we say that skeleton is made up of bones and joints. Okay, see students, when child born, the bones, the number of bones in child is 305. How much child bones? Okay, when child born, the number of bones are the skeleton of child contain 305 bones. When child start growing, what happened? The number of bones become increase or decrease? See student, in this case, adults have adult bones. How much? Any guess? Adult bones have 206. Skeleton is a framework which is made by bones. Okay. Then human skeleton is composed of around 3.5 bones at birth. The number of bones in the skeleton changes with age. It decreases to 206 bones or 206 bones by adulthood after some bones have fused together. The framework is called the skeleton. By feeling them, we say that our body is made up of bones. We also know this shape better when look at X-ray image of the human body. The X-ray shows the shape of the bones in our bodies. Our body is made up of bones. By touching, we can feel that our body is made up of bones. Press your finger. How you feel? You feel hard. Okay. See students, by feeling or by touching, we can imagine the image of bone. Okay. Press, we feel the hard part. The hard part requires bone. The hard part requires bone. Here is a, we feel bone. Another bone is connected. Okay. One bone is connected with another bone. So we can feel that our body is made up of bones. And another one option is there. We use X-rays. By using X-rays, we saw the image of bones. So X-ray is used to saw the image of bones. Not only to saw the image of bone, when someone get accident, that time we make X-ray. Why we make X-ray? Because to know about is any fractures or tear stress or bone was broken, by X-ray is made, we can easily saw the inside view of bone. So we use X-ray. Observe bones of the hand. Touch your finger and feel. Can you feel hard part? Hard part we call bones. Bones are hard. Hand is made up of several small bones. How hand is made up of? Hand is made up of bones. Is hand is made up of a single bone? Let's see students. Hand is made up of several bones. Just imagine, it's a picture of hand. See students, it's a picture or image of hand. We feel here our fingers are made up of three parts. Like here is also one bone, here is also one bone and another again bone. Okay, can you feel? Yes, by touching or by imagination you can feel the image of hand. The small bones combine to form a organ that is hand. The smallest bone of hand we call as carpals. What do you mean by carpals? Carpals means smallest bone of hand we call as carpals. system 33 vertebrae. Each small bone of vertebrae, that bone we call as vertebrae. There are 33 vertebrae in a single backbone. The ribcage is joined to the backbone. Instead of vertebrae, if backbone was made up of only one long bone, can we able to write? No, we already know that bones cannot be bent, but bones bend at the place of joint. Okay, no, we can't bend only a single bone. Vertebrae helps to bend our backbone. Try to identify the picture. See the activity. Apply force on wall with both hands. Press to the wall. Do you notice two bones on the back? These bones are called shoulder bones. It is image of shoulder bones. Next, see the picture. It is a picture of pelvic bones. This structure is made up of pelvic bones. Pelvic bones in our body we saw below the stomach. Below the stomach, which bone we saw? We saw pelvic bone. This is the part where we sit on. This part we call as pelvic bone. Observe and identify the picture. This is a picture of which picture? The picture of skull. Already we learned about skull. Skull is made up of many bones. How skull is made up of? Skull is made up of many bones. Means many bones join together and form skull. Skull envelopes and protects a very important part of the body. Tell me today, which is the important part covered by skull? The main and important part is brain. Skull protects the brain part. Observe the skeleton today. Skeleton is made up of bones. We already learned about bones. Head part of skeleton is made up of skull. Skull consists of many bones. Head part is connected to neck part. Head and neck part join at a point called midjoint. Recall, neck and head connected at a point. That joint we call as pivotal joint. Neck part again connected to, see the two bones, that we call as shoulder bones. Neck part again connected to the backbone also. We saw shoulder bones. Below shoulder bones, a cage is there. Which cage? We say rib cage. Rib cage is made up of ribs. Rib cage protects lungs and heart. Each chest part of rib cage or each chest part consists 12 ribs. Rib cage connected to backbone. Backbone is made up of how many vertebrae? Backbone is made up of 33 vertebrae. Vertebrae helps to bend. Below stomach part, we saw which bone? Below stomach part, we saw pelvic bone. Pelvic bone helps to sit. Observe hands. Hands are made up of how many bones? Hands are made up of small bones. The small bones of hands we call as carpals. We discussed many bones and the joints of our skeleton. Some not hard as the bone and which can be bent. Which part? Yes, you are correct. Ear part. The answer is ear. Touch and feel your ear. Do you find any hard bony part that can be bent? Yes. Yes, the bone is not as hard as the bone and it can be bent. We are cartilage. Do you notice any difference between the ear lobe and the portion above it? The upper part of the ear that is not as soft as the ear lobe, but not as hard as a bone. It is correct. This is cartilage. Cartilage is also found in the joint of the body. Students, if two bones are joined together, just imagine it's a bone. If two bones are joined together, we call that bones are joined together at a point, we call that joint. Here between the two bones, there is a layer. Which layer is there? We call as this layer, we call as cartilage. What we call? Cartilage. See, it is bone. Both are bone. Place where two bones are joined. We call as joint. Between two bones, one layer is there. This layer or gel we call as cartilage. Cartilage is not soft and not hard. It is not hard like a bone, but the cartilage we can bend. Okay. This is called as cartilage. This cartilage is present between the two bones. It helps to bend our body parts.
When muscle contacted,
has a large number of tiny bristles. What do you mean by bristle? Bristles means hair-like structure projecting out. The bristles are connected with muscles. The bristles help to get a good grip on the ground. It is about earthworm. Observe the picture and identify. Which picture is a picture of snake? See students, what are you observing in that picture? Have you seen the rounded structure it carries on its back? This is called the shell and it is outer skeleton of the snake. Which is the outer skeleton of the snake? Shell is the outer skeleton of the snake. But is not made of bones. The outer structure or shell is not made up of bones. The shell is a single unit and does not help in moving from place to place. It has to be dragged along. Shell is not made up of bone. It is also not helpful for moving a snake from place to place. A thick structure and the head of the snake may come out of an opening in the shell. The thick structure is its food. Its food means snail food made up of strong muscles. How snails' foods are made up of? Snails' foods are made up of strong muscles. Okay. Compared to earthworm, snails move slow. Next, observe the picture. Which picture is there? Picture of cockroach. Cockroaches walk and creep as well as fly in the air. They have three pairs of legs. How many pairs of legs are there? There are three pairs of legs. Three pairs means six legs. One pair is equal to two. Okay. One pair means two. Three pair means six. There are three pairs of legs in a cockroach. This helps in walking. The body is covered with a hard outer skeleton. How the body of cockroach is made up of? Body of cockroach is made up of outer skeleton. The outer skeleton is very hard. This outer skeleton is made of number of plates joined together and that permits movement. There are two pairs of wings attached to the body behind head. Instead of walking, cockroach also fly. For flying, it needs wings. How many wings are there in cockroach? Two pairs of wings. Pairs of wings means there are four wings attached to the body behind the head. The cockroach have distinct muscles, those near the legs. Move the legs for walking. The body muscles move the wings when the cockroach flies. Observe the picture of birds. How birds move? Birds move by walk and fly. Birds fly in the air and walk on the ground. Some birds like ducks and swans also swim in water. The birds can fly because their bodies are well suited for flying. See students, birds also contain bones, but modified as wings. The shoulder bones are strong. The wrist bones are modified to hold the muscles of flight, which are used to move the wings up and down. Observe the picture, students. Picture of fish. Observe the picture. The head and tail of the fish are smaller than the middle portion of the body. The body tapers at both ends. This body shape is called streamline. Which shape fish body is? Fish body we call as streamline. The shape is such that water can flow around it easily and allow the fish to move in water. The skeleton of the fish is covered with strong muscles. During swimming, muscles make the front part of the body curve to one side and the tail part swings towards the opposite side. The fish forming curve, then quickly the body and tail curve the other side. This makes a jerk and pushes the body forward. A series of such jerks make the fish swim ahead. This is helped by the fins of the tail. Fish also have other fins on their body, which mainly help to keep the balance of the body and to keep direction while swimming. Did you ever notice that underwater divers wear fin-like flippers on their feet to help them move easily in water? Muscles also interconnect the backbone, ribs and skin. The snake's body curves into many loops. Each loop of the snake gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. Since its long body makes many loops and each loop gives it this push, the snake moves forward very fast and not in a straight line. This is about gait of animals. See the important points from the topic body movements. First one is bones and cartilage form the skeleton of the human body. How human body skeleton is made up of? Bones and cartilage form a skeleton of human body. It gives the frame and shape to the body and help in movement. It protects the inner organ. Skeleton helps to protect the inner organs like skull protects brain and rib cage protects heart and lungs. So from this we say that skeleton protects the inner organ of our body. Next is the second point. The human skeleton comprises the skull, the backbone, ribs and the breastbone, shoulder and hip bone and Number of bones and joints are 206 bones for adult. For children, 305 bones. Next, observe the third point. The bones are moved by alternate contraction and relaxation of two sets of muscles. Next, the bone joints are of various kinds depending on the nature of joints and direction of movement they allow. Next point, strong muscles and light bones work together to help the bird fly. Which helps the bird fly? Strong muscles and light bones helps to fly the bird. They fly by flapping their wings. Fish swim by forming blows alternately on two sides of the body. From the head part and tail part, fish swims alternately on two sides. Next point, snakes filter underground by moving sideways. A large number of bones and associated muscles push the body forward. Next point, the body and legs of cockroaches have hard covering forming an outer skeleton. The muscles of the wrist connected with three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings help the cockroach to walk and fly. Next point, earthworm move by alternate extension and contraction of the body using muscles. Because earthworm didn't have bones, so it utilizes muscles. Tiny blister on the underside of the body help in the gripping the ground. Snail moves with the help of muscular foot because snail's leg made up of strong muscles. It helps to move. Okay students, today in this class we learned about skeleton is made up of number of bones and joints and learned about which are the joints and which are the bones. And we also learned about gaits of animals and body movements. Thank you.